After studying this module, you shall be able to know about the skeletal age and the various ossification centers, to understand the age changes in the bones of adults as well as old age. Skeletal age can be determined from the ossification of bones. That is helpful in the determination of age. The human bones develop from a number of ossification centers. At 11th to 12th week of intrauterine life, there are 806 ossification centers, and that at birth are reduced to about 450. Whereas the adult human is made up of 206 bones. The time of appearance of center of ossification and the process of union of the epiphyses with the diaphyses at the metaphyses have a sequence, and that time is utilized towards determination of age. The radiological survey of ossification centers may provide considerable help in estimating age of a person. However, we cannot place too much reliance over such method, as many factors affect the process of appearance and fusion of these bones, or you can say the ossification centers. Roughly, this method provides one parameter in conjunction with others to deduce age of a person, and it cannot be a superior criteria when considered in isolation. Similarly, it has to be remembered that the progression of fusion of bone is a process and not an event. So it may be liable for variation. The factors affecting the appearance and fusion of these centers are hereditary factors, the growth and development of a person, geographical variation, the climate, the dietary habits, as well as the association with diseases. All these factors affect the appearance and fusion of ossification centers. Let's see the ossification of bones. These ossification centers are studied up to the age of 20 to 22 years, and thereafter the skull wall sutures, union and activity of the sternum, changes in the shape of mandible, changes in the pubic symphysis are taken into account for determining the age. The ossification begins centrally in an epiphysis that spreads peripherally and gradually takes up the osteological details of the bony part. It is going to constitute, for example, upper end of femur, lower end of radius and ulna, etc. The union of epiphyses with the diaphyses in long bones is interpreted as united, recently united, uniting or non-uniting depending upon the stages of the union. When the epiphyseal lines persist, it is called recently united. The anatomical evidence of bony union differs from radiological union by about 3 years, and therefore radiographs give an earlier time of union. So in the living subjects, while determining the age of subjects to help the court of law in cases of dispute relating to age, radiological examination of the bones is undertaken. Now let's see the important ossification centers, their appearance in the body and their fusion. We see the medial end of the clavicle. The center of ossification appears at the age of 15 to 19 years. So there is a huge variation between the appearance. There's a gap of almost 4 years. So it may appear at 15 or it may appear as late as 19 years. So that is the age of appearance of the ossification center for the medial end of clavicle. However, it fuses by the age of 20 to 22 years. Center for sternum appears at the 5 months of intrauterine life, whereas it fuses at 60 to 70 years. Then the body of the manubrium, that it can be divided into 4 segments because there are the 5 parts of the body. So the first segment appears at the age of 5 months of intrauterine life, and it fuses. When we talk about the fusion of the manubrium, different segments of the body, they fuse at the age of 14 to 25 years from below upwards. So if we see precisely, the first and second segment of the body, the first segment appear at the age of 5 months of intrauterine life. The second segment appears at the age of 7 months of intrauterine life, second as well as third both, whereas the fourth segment appears at the age of 10 months of intrauterine life. When we talk about the fusion of these various segments, they fuse from below upwards at the age of 14 to 25 years. If we see, the first to fuse is the third and fourth, that is the age of 15 years. Then the second and third segment fuses with each other at around age of 20 years. And lastly, the segment first and second fuses, that happens around 25 years. So they fuse from below upwards from 14 to 25 years. Third part of the sternum or the chest plate is the xiphoid process. The ossification center for xiphoid process appears at the age of 3 years, and it is fused with the body at around age of 40 years or more. Then we see the humerus, the upper end of the humerus and the lower end of humerus. We can divide it into two because the ossification process is totally different. When we see at the upper end, center of ossification for the head appears at the age of 1 year and fuses at the age of 18 years. Whereas the ossification center for greater tubercle appears at the age of 3 years and fuses with the head at around age of 4 to 5 years. The center of ossification for lesser tubercle appears at the age of 5 years. And this, all these three centers, that is head, greater tubercle and lesser tubercle, they all three unite with each other at 6 years. And finally, at the age of 5 to 7 years, or they all, this lesser tubercle fuses with the greater tubercle. If we see the lower end of the humerus, the center of ossification for the medial epicondyle, that appears around the age of 5 to 6 years. For the capitulum appear at the age of 1 year. For trochlea appear at the age of 9 to 10 years. Whereas the lateral epicondyle appears at the age of 10 to 12 years. We see the fusion at the lower end of humerus. The capitulum, trochlea and lateral epicondyle, they form a conjoined tendon at around age of 14 years and they unite with shaft at around 15 years. The medial epicondyle unites at 16 years. So that is the last to ossify, to unite. We see the radius, the upper end of the radius, the ossification center appears at the age of 5 to 6 years and fusion is complete by the end of 15 to 16 years. Whereas the lower end of the radius, it appears at the age of 1 to 2 years and fuses at the age of 18 to 19 years. If we see the ulna, the upper end, the center of ossification appears at the age of 8 to 9 years and fuses at around 16 to 17 years. Whereas the lower end of ulna appears at the age of 5 to 6 years and fuses at the age of 18 to 19 years. If you see the head of the first metacarpal, the center of ossification appears at the age of 2 years and fuses at the age of 15 to 17 years. Whereas the head of all other metacarpals, they appear at the age of 1.5 to 2.5 years and fuse at around 15 to 19 years. We see the hip bone ossification activity. The triradiate cartilage, the center of ossification, appears at around 11 to 13 years and fuses at 14 to 15 years. The iliac crest appears at around age of 14 to 15 years and fuses at 18 to 20 years. The ischial tuberosity appears at the age of 15 to 16 years and fuses at the age of 20 to 22 years. The sacrum, the center of ossification, appears at the age of 8 months of intrauterine life, whereas they are fused around age of 25 years. All the 5 segments of sacrum fuse with each other by the end of 25 years. We see the femur, the upper end, again, the head, the greater trochanter and the lesser trochanter, the center for ossification appears differently. Head appears at 1 year and fuses at 17 to 18 years, whereas for greater trochanter, the center of ossification appears at the age of 4 years and fuses at the age of 17 years. Center of ossification for the lesser trochanter appears at the age of 14 years and fuses by the end of 15 to 17 years. We see the lower end of the femur, the center of ossification appears at 9 months of intrauterine life and fuses at 17 to 18 years of age. We see the tibia. The upper end of the tibia, again, the center of ossification appears at 9 months of intrauterine life and fuses at the age of 16 to 17 years. Whereas the lower end of tibia appears at 1 year of age and fuses at 16 years of age. We see the scapula, the coracoid base, coracoid process, the base, the center ossification appears at 10 to 11 years of age, whereas it fuses at around 14 to 15 years. The acromion process of the scapula, the center appears at 14 to 15 years and it fuses at 17 to 18 years. Now we see the age of ossification of various hand and foot bones. We see the carpels or the wrist bones, the carpels, the capitate, the age of ossification is 2 months, the hamate is at 3 months, the triquetral is 3 months, lunate is 4 months, scaphoid is 4 to 5 months, trapezium, trapezoid, again all these three at 4 to 5 months. Pisiform appear, the fuses at around 9 to 12 years. The calcaneum, again at 5 months, talus at 7 months, cuboid at 10 months, the lateral cuneiform at 1 year, medial cuneiform at 2 years, intermediate cuneiform at 3 years, and navicular also at 3 years. While determining the age of a subject for medico-legal purposes, the standard value obtained from examination of the number of subjects should be the guiding criteria, as individual variations for bony union tend to occur. The degree of growth and development of bones to some extent is affected by the dietary, environmental, hereditary, and endocrine factors in different individuals belonging to different regions and culture. Ossification occurs earlier in tropical climate compared to temperate zones. In females, in the general rule, epiphyseal union occurs 1 to 2 years earlier than the male. The maturation score for the estimation of skeletal age. To minimize the errors of epiphyseal union, McKern and Stewart in 1957 suggested a scheme of scoring involving 7 combinations of various segments. The total score is applied to prediction equation for more accurate estimation. The scoring is given based on the degree of epiphyseal union. That is, if there is no union, scoring is 1. If the 1/4 union, scoring is 2. Half union, scoring is 3. 3/4 union score is 4, the complete union a score of 5 is given. Now let us see the sutural closure of the skull. The estimation of adult age based on the cranial suture closure was one of the earliest methods of aging the skeleton to be developed. Much of the work in the beginning was conducted by Todd and Leon in the mid-1920s, and since this time, several authors have macroscopically analyzed the ecto and endocranial morphology of the sutures. While researchers describe sutural ossification as an age-related physiological process, in relation to age estimation for the forensic purposes, many find that it is highly variable and therefore unreliable as a method of age determination. Despite this, the closure of sutures of the skull has some bearing with the milestones of life. Absence of any signs of closure of any suture of the skull points to the strong possibility of the age having not exceeded 30 years. Evidence of commencing union of the sutures is always noticed first in the endocranial surfaces than on the ectocranial one. As a rule, inner surface closes several years before the outer. The sutural closure occurs earlier in males than females. Estimation of age from the closure of suture of a skull can be given within the range of 10 years between 30 to 60 years of age, and even more in higher age groups. The chronological age for the suture closure can be said as the lateral and occipital fontanelle close at around 2 months after birth. The posterior fontanelle closes at 6 to 8 months of birth. The anterior fontanelle closes at 1.5 to 2 years of birth. The metopic suture closes at 2 to 4 years, but may extend up to 6 years. The basioccipit and basisphenoid fuses at around 18 to 20 years of age. The sagittal suture is the first to start closing endocranially at about 25 years at its posterior portion, close to the parietal eminence. The fusion is complete both ectocranial and endocranial by the age of 35 to 45 years. The coronal suture starts closing endocranially by 25 to 30 years in its lowest part, close to the junction with the sphenoid, and is completely closed by the end of 40 years. The lambdoid suture starts closing endocranially at 25 to 35 years, and terminal closure occurs by 45 to 50 years. The tyrian starts closing at 40 years and completely closed by 65 years. The mastoideo-occipital suture starts closing at 45 years of age, and complete closure occurs at around 80 years of age. The asterion also closes by 80 years, and parietotemporal suture closes by 70 years. Now let's see the age changes in the bones in the adults and old age, other than the ossification processes and the cranial suture closure. Let's see the changes in the scapula. The scapula is a delicate bone and is often too damaged to be helpful. It requires experience to interpret, and also the changes do not seem to be constant. So the changes are not as closely identified with age as expected. The changes in the scapula can be divided into two categories: changes due to ossification after maturity and changes due to atrophic process after maturity. Let's see first the changes due to ossification after maturity. The lipping of glenoid fossa begins at around 30 to 35 years of age. Lipping of the clavicular facet begins at around 35 to 40 years of age. The appearance of plaque or facet on the underside of acromion process, thus prolonging the acromial trip from 2 to 8 millimeters at around 35 to 40 years of age. Increasing demarcation of the triangular area at the base of the scapular spine begins at 45 to 50 years of age. Then the appearance of crista scapularis that tend to become broader at the base and prominent at the apices with the advancing age. Then let's see the changes due to atrophic process after maturity. The surface vascularity. This is seen as number of fine lines in less than 25 years of old age. This visibility is slowly diminished and finally disappears with the advancing age. If we see the deep vascularity, it is seen as fine lines, but only by trans illumination by the age of 25 to 30 years. And they tend to diminish with the advancing age. The atrophic spots are areas of bone atrophy that starts appearing around 45 years, usually start in the infraspinous area. The buckling and pleating of infraspinous area is due to irregular atrophy of bone and is the result of diminished vascularity. It begins around the age of 40 years and there is absorption of cancellous tissue. Then let's see the changes in the pubic symphyseal surface. Aging is responsible for the fundamental contribution and provides a better guide than the skull sutures for age estimation. Todd's system states estimation of age from 10 stages of metamorphosis. The McKern and Stewart, that is more reliable method, have replaced Todd's system. In this method, symphysis pubis is divided into three components, of which six stages, that is from 0 to 5, are studies of metamorphic changes. A total score of three components is obtained, which in turn is translated into age provided the individual is male. Now there are the components, various components. Component 1, that is observed on the dorsal half of joint surface. There are again the six stages from stage 0 to stage 5. Stage 0 is the when the dorsal margin is absent. Stage 1, when the slight margin formation starts in the middle third. Stage 2, when the dorsal margin extends over the entire border. Stage 3, when there is a formation of pleotube, that is the filling of grooves and resorption of ridges, begins in the middle third of the dorsal surfaces. Then stage 4, there is visible billowing still present and pleotube extends over most of the dorsal surface. Then stage 5, billowing disappears completely and the surface becomes flat and slightly granular. Then component 2, if we see, observe, that is the ventral half of joint surface. So first was the dorsal half of joint surface, that is component 1, and component 2 is the ventral half of joint surface, whereas component 3 will be the combination of both surfaces. We see the component 2, that is the ventral half of joint surface, stage 0 when the ventral beveling is absent. Stage 1, when the ventral beveling present at the superior extremity and the ventral border. Stage 2, when the beveling extend downwards. Stage 3, when there is bony extension, what is called as ventral rampart, that begins from either or both the extremities. Stage 4, when ventral rampart extend still further, but gaps are still visible. And stage 5, when ventral rampart is complete. The component 3, there is a combination of both whole surface. We say stage 0 when symphyseal rim is absent. Stage 1 when the dorsal rim appears at superior end of the dorsal margin. It is smooth and raised above the symphyseal surface. Stage 2 when the dorsal rim is complete and ventral rim starts forming. Stage 3, when symphyseal rim is complete and surface is finally granular. Stage 4, when rim begins to break down, is sharply defined, the surface becomes smooth and flat with no lipping of the ventral edge. Stage 5, there is further background of rim and rarefaction of the symphyseal surface. The joint lipping begins along the vertebral edge during the last two stages of component 3 at about 35 to 40 years. Now, how to roughly estimate the age with the help of these changes at the pubic symphysis? When the symphyseal surface is even, age is less than 20 years. When the surface is markedly rigid and irregular, which is called as billowing, the ridges running transversely across the articular surface, the age is between 20 to 25 years. When the billowing gradually disappears and the articular surface becomes granular with sharp anterior and posterior margins, the age is around 25 to 35 years. When the articular surface is smooth and oval, the age is 35 to 45 years. The narrow and beaded rim develops in and around the margins of articular surface, and some erosion of the surface starts by the age of 45 to 50 years. And there is varying degree of erosion with breaking down of ventral margin, the ages 50 to 60 years. And the surface becomes irregularly eroded after about 60 years of age. And let's see the age changes in the vertebra. By the time the deciduous dentition is completed, that means the permanent dentition is completed, the arch unites posteriorly, and at the same time the arches and bodies of the lowest lumbar vertebra begins to fuse. The posterior parts begin to fuse by 6 years, and at the same time the arches of the first cervical vertebra unite posteriorly. The upper and lower surfaces of immature vertebra shows a series of radial furrows, the age is 10 years. The furrows gradually fade on the upper and lower surface between the age of 21 to 25 years. And the lipping of vertebra is seen usually after age of 45 years. The osteophytic outgrowth from anterior and lateral margins become visible by the age of 40 to 45 years. The second cervical vertebra up to the age of about 3 years consists of three pieces, that is two lateral portions that constitute the arch, the body and the dens. Then let's see the age changes in the internal bony structure. Two structural components are studied, that is the cancellous tissue and the cortical tissue. The cancellous tissue, for studying this, the humerus and femur are mainly considered, of which humerus is used on the priority basis. The methods used are radiological examination of bones and longitudinal section of bones, in which resorption pattern of the cancellous tissue is examined. The proximal end of the medullary cavity of the humerus assumes a cone shape, the tip of which gradually reaches the surgical neck of the bone during the period of 40 to 50 years and further ascends up to the epiphyseal line by 60 to 75 years. Cortical tissue, if we see, the cortical elements are the osteon fragments, the lavener bones and the non-haversial canals. They are studied microscopically and the age could be ascertained within the margin of 5 years. By counting the osteons in cross-section of bone, the age can be ascertained, but it is not an accurate and reliable method. To summarize the topic, the skeletal age can be determined from the ossification of bone, that is helpful in determination of the age. Radiological survey of ossification centers may provide considerable help in estimating age of a person. The ossification centers are studied up to the age of 20 to 25 years. Thereafter, the skull wall sutures, union activity of the sternum, changes in the shape of mandible, changes in the pubic symphysis are taken into account. While determining the age of a subject for medico-legal purposes, the standard value obtained from examination of the number of subject should be the guiding criteria, as there are a lot of individual variation in the bony union. The ossification occurs earlier in tropical climates compared to temperate zones, and in females compared to males by the period of 1 to 2 years.